Are you going to take them all before they get here?
What I've often said is my philosophy is actually regarded by a lot of zoo people as heresy, but I believe that in a sense, and I say this as an oversimplification, but in a sense the animals are almost incidental to your experience when you're going through the zoo.
There's a feel of wilderness here, an illusion of walking down a dirt road in eastern Africa. I'm at the African savanna, just one of several exhibits that have made Woodland Park a world-class zoo. The moving force behind its success has been David Hancocks, a talented man with a remarkable philosophy of zookeeping. But suddenly, after 7 years, Hancocks has resigned as its director.
My main reason for going has been that after 2 years of still no... And this zoo has not had any capital development money voted for it for 15 years. And the frustrations of trying to continually make improvements without money eventually become too much.
Yet the zoo that Hancocks is leaving is a far better place than it was when he arrived.
It was a little miniature menagerie that told stories about animals that I think confused us and depressed us at the same time. Monkeys living in on rock piles with little red schoolhouses didn't tell us anything about monkeys, didn't make us very happy. I think made it difficult even for parents to describe to children what they were seeing.
Oh, Sarah, look at the zebras.
The newer exhibits make sense, and they're exciting too, thanks in large part to David Hancocks. An architect by training, Hancocks helped design zoos in London and Bristol, England, before coming to Seattle in 1975. His vision was to make animals part of a living landscape.
The concrete cages and tiled walls of the past weren't really designed for animals. They were designed for hoses. What I think we should do is create replicas of the natural habitat so that you enjoy and get all your senses involved in enjoying those natural landscapes. And then you see the animal as a part of that total environment. What zoos typically have done is taken the animal and exhibited as an object that's totally divorced from nature. And when you do that, the animal loses all that sense of magic and mystery that it's got in the wild.
In the old exhibits, animals were grouped and confined by type, so that all the apes were kept in one house and all the cats in another. But Hancocks has directed the zoo toward exhibits that group animals as you would see them in nature. And he has given them more space, so that zebras, giraffes, and springboks roam together near secretary birds, paddock monkeys, and hippos, just as they do in the savanna of Africa.
Okay.
Aww. Do you like the savanna?
Yeah, this
Real
is
nice.
The nicest part of the zoo compared to the monkeys and so far.
You don't like the monkey exhibits?
Not necessarily. It didn't seem as natural. They seem more in their natural habitat here. They seem to be having a good time.
I think psychologically it's just much better for the animal. Expanding the exhibit as we did, as you can see, they now have a large area to utilize. Their behavior has significantly changed from just being a big brown furry blob.
There were many people, however, that had some reservation about an architect becoming a zoo director. I don't think that any other zoo director who might have been trained in zoology or vet medicine or in another discipline would have had the sensitivity and could have provided this leadership.
As a pioneer, Hancocks had to convince the world he was right.
The rest of the zoo world thought, they started hearing these stories about these, for instance, the gorilla exhibit with the gorillas allowed to climb into live trees up 40 feet in the air, and we would get these reactions, you know. You can't do that. Being born in captivity, wouldn't have the skills to climb, they'd fall and hurt themselves, but David had a lot of courage about all this.
I quite often go behind the scenes at night and feed him strawberry yogurt, And he's come down because he recognizes me, and I'm not giving him, I cannot give him what he wants. And this is why he's knocking on the glass and saying, trying to attract my attention. Yeah, I'm sorry, I can't do it.
But while its new exhibits are the best in the world, the old ones are an embarrassment. Worst of all is the elephant house, a leaking, ramshackle exhibit designed for holding one elephant in chains for all its life. A new facility will cost $2 million, but Seattle voters have rejected the last two bond issues, and private contributions have been minuscule.
Here, where we know we can solve the problem and we want to, we cannot get the money, and so there's tremendous frustration.
Seattle is only going to get as good a zoo as it deserves and wants, says Hancocks. His sudden resignation, along with the defeat of the last bond issue, now raise the question of whether his vision for Woodland Park will ever be fulfilled. For Evening Edition, this is David Boeri.